Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Revived Witch on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Revived Witch and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Revived Witch. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else my friends, to get started we have to open our main web browser. We have here the one we use by default. Let's continue, going to that URL that I'm highlighting in green. Now, you are able to see on the screen. There is no need to type anything, because I provided a clickable link in the video description and as well in the first main comment. We ended up on this page on the website of Usitility, exactly where we find here a detailed explanation on the way to download and install Revived Witch on PC. We search lower a little bit and click on the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on that link, we reach the website of BlueStacks. No panic, it is just the Android emulator that we are going to use to enjoy the game Revived Witch on our PC. It is now obvious that we have a number of pros of running that emulator. So we are on the way to proceed to download the Revived Witch by clicking on the button play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green. We then click on it. Of course, the download starts and ends immediately. Here it is, this is the download. It is a file to execute. What we have to do now is to launch the installer, okay, so we have to click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to allow changes to the device. We said yes. I minimize the web browser to view the installer much better. The installation software is quite simple. It includes two options, install and setup path. I will explain what setup path really does. We only simply click on it. And therefore we discover that we have now here the path in which the emulator will be set up. If we wish to change this folder we are required to click on the Browse button, and now we opt for another directory and set up the emulator wherever we prefer. To keep it simple, just set it as it is. Then, I click on Back. Therefore I just click on Install. Fantastic. The install begins and it will continue in the download of these megabytes which are visible on the screen. Once you download it, it could be slightly more or less megabytes. The download rate can be at a higher speed or slower, determined by your web access and according to the efficiency of the emulator hosting servers. At the moment, they're working superbly fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5, you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At present, the emulator has actually been launched automatically. As you can discover, at the bottom of the screen, there's a progress bar that will fill up and once it gets to the end, the emulator can be started for the first time. The fact is that the emulator is already launched, here it is for the first time. Before we keep going, as can be seen, it made two icons there on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon is definitely the only one we are considering. Anytime we need to operate Revived Witch on the desktop or laptop, we twice mouse-click on that software icon and therefore start the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Shall we make the following step, which is a must, and this is to access the Google Play Store. And we are going to mouse-click on Play Store. As you understand the Google Play is presented. Right here we have to sign in. Presently the moment we are here, we are required to execute the next step that is absolutely mandatory. So we click on, Sign In. Presently it announces, checking info. It may sometimes get stuck in, checking info, that's why it does not move ahead. In this case, you should try to log in after a few hours it's going to almost certainly be repaired. At this time we shall insert our login name and password. The email address must be a Gmail email as well as its associated password. For example, you may use the same email you use at this moment in your YouTube account. So that I will submit my information and I'll return immediately after I have accomplished it. Voila, information inserted. Here is Google welcoming us and providing us their terms of service. we will approve them all by clicking on I agree. Following that, it allows us to backup to the Google Cloud. You can leave it selected and it will create a backup of your data on this device to Google Drive. I won't select it, you do what you want. We click on accept. Google Play, formerly Android Market, is started automatically. To install the application, we need to go to the Android emulator desktop by simply clicking on this icon marked green colored. At present that we are exploring the desktop of this emulator, we observe that we find here the install game option. We then click on the button. Listed here we access to the video game. So let's click on now on the install button that I'm showing now in green color. That click will initiate the setup. Now it should download on your laptop or computer and install the game. It could take a bit of time or it could be extremely fast. It again all relies on our own connection to the internet. It's by then ended installing. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by simply clicking this particular button that I am emphasizing in green, in order to launch Revived Witch for the first time. You are presently on the emulator desktop, and therefore we are about to just click this new Revived Witch app icon which was created. Your Android game is launched for the first time. Currently there we end up with it, I can click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I have to talk about the volume level of the emulator. It is right here. We have the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume. This manner we don't depend on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of your emulator. And also to appreciate the experience to the max, we can turn on the large monitor, for which we have two options. This one is simply the first one, we click on this app icon that I am identifying in green color. Thus the display screen is maximized, coming with one border at the top, one at the right and one at the bottom. In case that we like to experience the game in full screen, we select this icon. And as a consequence we would probably at present be enjoying the video game in 100% screen mode. To leave the 100% screen functionality, push the F11 key. And thus we would definitely at present be in normal display screen mode. At present, I am ready to present you the keyboard mapping which is certainly very appealing. That step we will certainly be able to utilize the game application much more effortlessly. The very first point is to press the software icon. And at this time there you will have the ability to get the necessary adjustments. I'll go ahead and leave the default settings, though if you like to change it, you may very well achieve it without having problem. As you can observe, the emulator is absolutely in our language. Sometimes it happens that your emulator is launched in the wrong language, for instance, in Mandarin. And thus to set it up in the correct language we go here to the cogwheel. And thus right here inside of other configurations, we just click the language drop down. We could decide on the language we prefer, German, Chinese, etc. Once the language is determined, we should save, the emulator will restart, and also the game application, next time we run it, will also be in the specified language. Presently, you will find another element that we must take into account, and this is that we will receive a message from Gmail telling that a different device has been connected to our Google account. It will definitely question us if we're the people who have associated with that electronic device. Yep, we must not be troubled, since the emulator is behaving like an Google Android tablet or smartphone. So you can identify which electronic device is being emulated, we arrive right here, to the cogwheel and we just click on it. Let's browse here to the model choice. And here we discover that the emulator is simulating a Samsung cell phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it guys, so much for that tutorial. I believe you appreciated it, especially that you thought it was interesting. If that's the case, give it a great thumb up, subscribe, and if you have remarks, issues or ideas, put them in the comment field down below. You also can leave comments on my Twitch channel, I actually do live streams occasionally, you get it listed below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Simply click any of those videos that are appearing on the computer screen and see you in the following video tutorials. Bye.